We first used Hashgraph for enterprise applications, and we developed the code base to be enterprise grade for those customers. But we always knew that was just phase one. And we were patient, thoughtful, sober-minded, and made plans for phase two. Tonight, I'm pleased to introduce you to Hedera. It is a public platform, a public Hashgraph network with a world-class governing council. In Hedera, we have solutions to these problems. It's built on the Hashgraph platform. This is the same platform that we've been building for years and delivering to our enterprise customers and partners. Tonight, Lehman is going to make some important announcements about the performance of our platform that we haven't yet released to the public. In terms of security, Hashgraph as an algorithm achieves a gold standard of security in the world of distributed consensus. It's called Asynchronous Byzantine Fault Tolerance. What does that mean? Practically, what that means is that Hashgraph is resilient to distributed denial of service attacks that other platforms simply aren't. Any platform that has a leader or a coordinator or some type of synchronous process that it depends on is susceptible to DDoS attacks. Representative algorithms are Paxos and Raft and PBFT and DPoS. In addition, Hashgraph addresses a whole set of concerns that other platforms don't even consider today. We refer to this property in Hashgraph as fairness. It brings fairness to the consensus system itself. It ensures that transactions actually count as happening when they reach the network. It also ensures that there's no single party that can prevent transactions from entering the network, nor can a single party control the final consensus that the community ultimately agrees upon. No single party can influence the order of transactions for the community. In other words, practically, what I'm saying is that Hashgraph can, for the first time, directly address the creation of provably fair markets, auctions, time-limited business transactions, and games. Only Hashgraph has this fairness property and has math proofs that it, in fact, exists in the algorithm. Well, what about stability? The Hedera platform provides a set of controls that makes it possible to actually bring stability to the platform. Tonight, Lehman will introduce a concept that we call state proofs. And simply stated, state proofs make it impossible for a network node running in the platform to make a copy of the platform, an official copy, a copy of the official ledger, if you will, make changes, and then pass off those changes as being accepted or valid. Hedera also makes it possible, the state proofs make it possible for the governing body to specify what changes should be made to the nodes, but then ensure the precise time that those changes are applied to the nodes in the network, and guarantee that they are applied to the nodes in the network. In addition, Hedera brings legal controls to the platform that others don't have. The Hashgraph technology is patented. What does that mean for you? First off, no license is required to use the platform. No license is required to use the services. No license is required to build smart contracts on the platform. The software that you end up developing is your software. You can license it however you want, and it will not be encumbered in any way by Hedera. You never even have to talk to us if you want to build product applications on top of the platform. That's not what the patent is for. In addition, what we are going to do with version 1 is release the source code for open review. Anybody that wants to take a look at the source code will be able to do so, download it, read it, review it, compile it, and verify that it's correct in the same source code or the same product that is being downloaded to be run in the nodes of the network. The bottom line is that we will have a stable, transparent platform that encourages both open innovation, but the code base and the cryptocurrency will not fork. Hedera will not fork. I promise you. Well, if we have those mechanisms to provide a stable platform, what's the right governance model? You know, what is it that we should build in terms of governance that is equal to the technology that we brought to the table? We have a split governance model. Open consensus with permission governance. Open consensus simply refers to the notion that anybody that wants to run a node in our network will be able to do so. At scale, we anticipate there will be millions of nodes in the network. They'll be running these nodes on regular computers. Nodes run by regular people on regular computers. Okay? In addition, we have a permission governance model for the organization itself, the operations of Hedera as an organization. What does that mean? Well, when it comes to pricing, technical roadmap, legal aspects of the organization, marketing, regulatory concerns, all of the parts of the business, for this we have established a council. We have taken and applied the design theory that was first introduced by Dee Hock back in the 1960s when Dee founded Visa. Prior to it being Visa, it was Bank Americard. We've taken his design principles and applied them to Hedera's governance model. This is a model that is not in the market today, but we believe solves the governance problems that we see in our industry today. There are 39 industry leading organizations that will end up being a part of this organization that provide the governing council. These members will provide expertise in business, technical aspects, legal, regulatory, all of the things I've previously mentioned. We're not just going to have a list of advisors. We are going to have a council of decision makers that are providing the stewardship of the platform and the associated cryptocurrency. We are working to finalize the governance terms. When these discussions and work is completed, we will make an announcement about who these members are within the organization. So what about the platform? Where are we in this process? Right? There is a test network up and running today on three continents. It's built on top of the same platform that we've already used for enterprise applications, the Hashgraph consensus platform that we've already taken to market. On top of that platform, there is a cryptocurrency service that supports native microtransactions, micropayments. In addition, we have a distributed file storage system for applications built on top of the platform that brings a set of security guarantees that I think are new and unique in the market. Lehman will talk about that a little bit later tonight. And then finally, what about smart contracts, right? Everybody wants to know about smart contracts. We've taken the Ethereum virtual machine, we put it directly on top of the platform. We support Solidity scripts out of the box, right? All of this is happening now. Today, the test network is restricted to internal testing and working with a few beta customers. That will change very quickly. I'm anticipating that we will begin to open up the network to additional beta customers as early as May. Maybe the end of April, as early as the first part of May. And of course, yes, there is a token, a coin associated with this platform. Why is it that we have a coin? There are two reasons. Number one, you have to have a cryptocurrency or at least a scarce resource in a public ledger to provide the security of the ledger. In a public ledger, there has to be something that provides scarcity to prevent certain categories of attacks against the consensus process. The cryptocurrency provides the needed scarcity. So the cryptocurrency actually is required to ensure the security of the network. Secondly, when applications use the platform and they make API calls to the services I've just listed, at the same time, they will be making micropayments for the use of those APIs. So with every API call, a micropayment will be made using the platform cryptocurrency. In other words, the token is needed for the functioning of the platform. In summary, we have solutions for the categories of problems that I've outlined previously. We provide the needed technology, security, stability, and a governance model that we believe will move the industry forward in a way that it's previously not been able to achieve. Thank you. This symbol is called an H-bar. And tonight, we are dramatically raising the bar for the industry. Tonight, we are raising the H-bar. Right? So we are going beyond one small group of nodes to provide consensus, beyond one person to control the code base, beyond one company to trust for expertise, beyond one sector of applications and use cases, and beyond one government for the stability of a global cryptocurrency. We are Hedera, and tonight we welcome you to the future.